Hello everyone, and welcome to Fabric Tech Talk Fridays, your go-to place for everything Fabric. I am here with MVP extraordinaire, Heidi. Heidi, before we get started, why don't you tell the people who you are and what you do?
Hi everyone, my name's Heidi Hastings. I'm from Australia. I'm one of the data platform MVPs. My day-to-day, I'm working all things data and all things Microsoft. And in my spare time, I love traveling around the world and talking to all of you in the community about all things data and all things Microsoft. It's kind of like a win-win for me.
Wow, Heidi. I see you everywhere I go, except when I go to Australia, New Zealand, where you're from.
I know. Everyone sees me abroad.
Yeah, that's right.
I have to say, like, I'm in country, I'm at home today, because I'm traveling so much.
But. Okay, so I do a lot of work with Fabric. You know, and a lot of times organizations or companies or individuals like myself, the last thing we think about is version control, right? And so we don't think about it. Version control and governance. Version control and governance are the last things we think about. But today we're going to talk about that. You're going to educate me.
Absolutely. Okay. We're absolutely going to talk about all things version control. And we're going to make sure that the audience knows that version control doesn't have to be hard. It's actually quite easy once you get started. But you got to know where to start. So that's what we're going to show people today.
All right. So enough of all this talking, Heidi. Let's head over to your laptop.
So you're going to look and you're going to go, I'm starting with Azure DevOps, right?
But
so
I'm confused. I start Fabric. I don't start
I know.
DevOps.
No. We can start with DevOps. And the reason we're going to start with DevOps is because we need a team project. We need somewhere that we're going to link to our Fabric to do our version control. Now, yes, we could have used GitHub, but today I'm going to show you Azure DevOps, right?
Okay.
So this is our home screen for Azure DevOps. We're going to go create a new team project. We need to have a project. So let's call it Fabric Tech Talk Friday.
All right.
And we are going to use Git.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we're going to go let that create. While that's creating, that's going to create a brand new team project for us. And in that project, we're going to have a repository.
Okay.
The repository is the thing that we want to store all our Fabric items. So we're going to go in here into the repositories and the repos, Azure repos as it's commonly known, and we're going to initialize so that we've got somewhere to store our Fabric items.
So all the things I create in Fabric, warehouses, lakehouses, all those things, we're going to pull those over into this repo. Oh.
Almost all of them. We're working towards all of them, but at least some of them.
Yep.
You really want to use this rather than not have it. So let's switch on over to Fabric, your space, Fabric, Patrick.
Space. Yeah, my space.
We're going to go to our workspace. We're going to create a new workspace, right?
Okay.
We're going to create our Fabric Talk Talks Friday. We're doing our brand new project. I'm just going to put it on a trial one for now, but you can have it on a Fabric capacity. It's important to have it in a Fabric capacity in some way because this is a Fabric only feature.
Let's make sure people understand what we're saying here. So the only time you can use Git version control, your workspace needs to be connected to some type of Fabric capacity. And it doesn't matter the SKU. It could be an F2 all the way down to an F, whatever the biggest one is these days.
Super inclusive is source control.
Yeah.
F2 all the way through all the F SKUs, but you have to have a capacity to use this feature.
Awesome, okay.
So now we've got our workspace.
Yep.
No source control. So if I went and created items here, there is no option for me to have a copy of those somewhere that I can just quickly go, oh no, I lost the view, let me put it back.
Okay.
So what we want to do is we want to go to these workspace settings. So you have to be a workspace admin to do this. You go into the workspace settings, we're going to go into the Git menu, right?
Mm.
We're going to Git. Git is the style of version control. Industry recognized Git. It's used by both Azure DevOps and GitHub.
Yep.
It's also used by other third-party products like GitLab, but those ones aren't directly integrated.
Now, I see something here that's interesting. So you're using Azure DevOps, but this also supports GitHub. So I can choose. I can pick and choose which one I like better.
Absolutely. Absolutely, you can use GitHub. Now, up until the FabCon conference just recently, you had to use, if you went GitHub, you had to use a PAT token. So people were like, oh, I don't really like that.
Mm-hmm.
But now the connectivity there is way better. Your security team will thank you for it. We're gonna go Azure DevOps. Now, oh, by the way, if GitHub is grayed out, there's a tenant setting to enable it.
Okay.
So don't worry. If you get it and it's grayed out, make sure you enable that tenant setting first. So you saw we were in Azure DevOps earlier, so we're going to pick that org, so it's my Heidi demo. Then we're going to pick the project we created, so we've got the Fabric Tech Talks Friday. We're going to pick the repository. We initialized that repository earlier. Now, I'm not going to pick a branch here. I'm just going to use the main.
Okay.
But if we were doing more development, we'd do feature branching and we'd go down that path. And we can put multiple workspaces in the same repository. Mm. So if I've got my Power BI reports in one workspace with my semantic model, and I got my lakehouse and my warehouse in another one, and my pipelines and notebooks, they can both go to the same repository. You get to choose how you want to architect your source control. Wow.
It's very flexible and nimble,
It is.
Yeah.
So now we're connected. See, we're all connected here. You can see we're all connected up, but there's nothing there, right?
Yeah.
So if I went back to my Azure DevOps, nothing there either.
Okay.
So we come back, we're going to create a new item. And I'm going to go with one that we can definitely put into source control. So we're going to use the warehouse. We're going to use a sample so that you can see that data doesn't go into that source control.
I was going to ask you that question, but you're reading my mind.
We only want to make sure we have the structure of our warehouse. So we can call it warehouse 01. We're going to add that. Now, just creating it there, it's not automatically going into our source control.
Okay.
It's going to go ahead and create that warehouse.
Okay, so now once this warehouse is created, there's data in this warehouse. And I want to make sure that doesn't get over in the version control, because I don't want data outside of my Fabric workspace.
Exactly. Well, let's just confirm with everyone so they can see behind the scenes.
Okay.
There is data. So when we're previewing, now this is just sample data, so this is not client or customer data that we're seeing here.
No PII.
No PII.
Okay.
We've just got dates, right?
Okay.
No data. Now, this is not yet in source control, so we're going to go back to our workspace. Now you will see we got this little source control menu here.
Indicator.
Knows that you put something there and it's not yet in source control.
Okay.
It's not going to tell you though about the data site.
Okay.
So we go in, we see we've got our warehouse item. It needs to be added. So we can come in here and say, we're adding the new sample warehouse.
So we're giving it a little note to let it know what we're doing.
Absolutely.
When we do this check-in. Okay.
Version control 101, useful comment to help future self when someone goes, what changed? You look at that history comment and you can see what's changed.
I love it.
So we're going to go ahead and commit.
Okay.
Now that's where it's going to take the definition of our warehouse. Just the definition.
Only the definition, not the data. Okay.
Now we know metadata is still data.
Sure.
That's why we use the words definition. So it's taking that, it's generating a SQL project and putting that into source control. So now when we flick over to our Azure DevOps,
it
looks empty. We do our refresh and now we're going to see a folder there called warehouse. That is our Fabric warehouse item, but it is not the data. So we go into that date table where we were looking at the preview. We're not looking at the preview of the data here. We're looking at the definition of that date table.
Yeah.
Now we can make changes here, and we can make changes in Fabric.
Really? They sync back?
Yeah. So when you've got developers who love using source control, and they want to use things like SQL Server Management Studio, Visual Studio Code, Visual Studio, they can clone this Git repository, make changes, put it into Azure DevOps. Then what happens if they make a change is when you go back to Fabric, this source control will now say there's an update and you can sync it back in. So you can go both ways and work with the tools that you prefer.
Now, what I noticed down in the bottom left of your screen, I noticed there's a little indicator there that's letting me know, hey, this is under version control. This is under source control.
Is.
Yeah, I see
and
that.
And it lets you know what branch you want. Branching can be overwhelming, so we're not going to go through it today, but do definitely look into it, because at the moment we're working with just our main branch.
Yeah.
But when we want to have lots of developers and lots of different features working on the fly, we can have different Fabric workspaces for different branches.
Okay, now I got a big question, Heidi. I got a big question. So I write a lot of SQL and I've built a lot of data warehouses in my life. And so this particular one, there's some tables and some stored procedures, but data warehouses change, they evolve, they grow.
Yeah.
And I need to add something, but I need to get that into my source control. Can the fabric handle this?
It can totally handle it.
Okay,
so let's go to our warehouse. Let's say we want to create a view.
Yeah.
So we're going to take this, we're going to do a new SQL query.
Mm-hmm.
We'll just do top 1000.
Sure.
Let's turn that into a view. Woo. We're going to create the view. Let's call it DBO.view1. Now, definitely don't follow this naming convention.
I love that convention, Heidi. I love that convention for me.
There we go. So we got our view.
Yep.
We're going to create that view.
Yep.
Let's run it.
Yep.
Let's make sure. So we got our view. There we go. There's our view 01.
Okay.
Now, if we script this out, we can see that this is view 01. This is exactly what the database project's going to do. So we can look at that. If we create that script, it's going to look the same.
Okay.
No change.
Yep.
Now we go back to our workspace.
Yeah.
Because anytime we want to go to and fro source control, we want to come from the workspace level. So look at that. It already knew I did something. It looked modified. We can go in and say, look, we added view 01. Now we commit that.
Okay.
Now we get even more cool features, right?
Right.
So that's going to take that view, it's going to push it over into source control. Now if we go to the source control, we can see that our view is there. We'll do a refresh. it's already there without the refresh.
Wow. See?
And even better is if we look at the history, so we come back up here, look at that.
Wow.
That's why my comment is really important, because really future important. Self is going to go, what did you change in the last week? And you can see it.
This is amazing.
Look how easy that was. And we now have our warehouse in version control. Someone makes a mistake, they delete a store procedure, they edit the view, and they get it wrong. It's okay, because you can come back to the history and we can get it back.
Absolutely.
We can look at what changed in that view, we can reverse the change, and we can sync back.
Yeah.
So now Fabric has the correct version of the view.
Wow.
Win-win.
It's like I can time travel. I can go back in time, right? Kind of like back to the future or back to the past. I don't know, but it's absolutely amazing. But the thing here is that I don't have to worry about my data being affected by having this under version control. It's absolutely amazing. Thank you so much, Heidi, for educating us on all this version control. All right, everyone. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments about the video or for Heidi, be sure to post them in the comments below. If this is your first time visiting the Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button. And as always, from Heidi, Swetha, myself, thanks for watching. We'll see you next Friday. Thank you everyone for watching. If you found this video valuable, don't forget, hit that like button.
If this is your first time visiting the Microsoft Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to smash that subscribe button.
Drop a comment below on what you'd like to see on future episodes of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
That's it for today. See you all next Friday for another deep dive into Microsoft Fabric.